goes to Crosby and right back to Malkin. The shot and a save made by Hellebuck. He controls the rebound, and then Hornquist is dumped long after the whistle.
As he should have been for whacking the goaltender. And that's exactly what the job of the defenseman is. You know, Hornquist, he gets a lot away with a lot in front of the net. And after a beautiful passing, here's a shot. Watch the stick. Bang. Just whacks the pads of Hellebuck. And a price to be paid for that. I have no problem. I don't think Hornquist has any problem with that, guys. He took a waffle right in the chops on the road in Carolina. That was pretty easy there.
The big thing about Brad Boyd, you think about when he was a top rated player. Look at it. Oh, and Cam Jansen ran right over him. The place has the gloves on. He wants Jansen, and they're going to get him out of there. Hellebuck holding on to everybody.
Yeah, this is a bad matchup for the Canadians because some of the bigger boys, for the St. Louis Blues, are on the ice. And I'll tell you one thing, Price and Conklin want to go, and they both know how to do it.
Better Price and Conklin with Price and Jansen. And maybe with Jansen in the lineup, Jones will not. Should have been Montreal.
I don't understand that call, Chris. I got to tell you honestly, I was talking to Cam Jansen before the game. He said, I don't have a dance partner with Ryan slide in there.
It's passed back to the line, intercepted by Pasternak. Marchand breaking up the middle. Pass was deflected. He gets through to Riddick. And then Marchand takes a chop at Riddick, and that'll draw a reaction as Hamonic runs over Brad Marchand. We're taking a jab at his goaltender.
Now Marchand, he came in there a little bit late, and Hamonic took exception to it. Look at Riddick. He's got his arms up. Said, I had that puck covered. Like, what gives here, guys? And this is what Marchand does. He's got that ability to be on the line, and he likes to go over it from time to time right in there. Look at the response from big Travis Hamonic, who had that big assist on the game-winning goal in New York in his homecoming. But
one-handed face-off wins in the NHL.
Yeah, at 60.4.
Play back it over the line. Smith out to play. Oh. Smith got run that time. Oh. Yeah, and now let's...
Gloves are off. Here we go. Yard sale. Hanson dropped his gloves from the blue line.
Martin Hanson went right in.
Well, this is a 5-on-4 situation here. I'm sure Mike Smith's going to get involved here. He's grabbing somebody. Let's see if Schneider comes. This will fire up the boys. And Rusty Klesla has someone strung out.
Martin, well, that was reminiscent of the Chicago series last April.
Yeah, that was Edler. He's going right to the locker room. As he just flattens Mike Smith, who came out to play that puck. I would have loved to see Mike Smith grab someone. Fire his teammates up. Yeah, that's what this team needs, is an old-fashioned brawl. And there it is right there. Edler makes no effort to get the puck, just runs him right over. Hits him right in the head. Yeah, I think he's going to get a 5-minute major for this.
Mike Smith appears to be fine.
Dans le coin. Et Dykhouse qui a jonglé avec le 10. Là, c'est Théodore qui s'amène rapidement. Bon jeu de sa part. Mais... D'une part, Théodore a été blessé. Gilmore a voulu venger son gardien de but.
Et Gilmore avait bien vu le jeu de Varada. Puis Varada, lui, a joué pour blesser. C'est là ce qu'on a mentionné, que Jean-Pierre Dumont avait tenté de blesser Hackett. Non, mais dans ce cas-là, on a vu la façon dont Varada a vraiment sorti du jeu pour essayer d'ébranler le gardien de but. Gilmore a bien vu ça et a défendu
son gardien
José
de but.
Théodore.
Oui. Bon, alors José qui reçoit, lui, les premiers soins. Il en a perdu son masque protecteur.
Le tout a débuté avec une rondelle qui a débuté sur le long de la rampe, qui était coincée ici et qui a frappé une jambière.
Et là, les deux entraîneurs, Michel Therrien et Lindy Ruff, sont debout sur le banc. Ruff, évidemment, en a contre Gilmore, alors que Therrien, lui, en a contre Varada.
C'est toujours la réplique, c'est un peu ça, l'intention de blesser. Ça dépend du gardien de but, José Théodore.
Alors, tout ça, ça survient avec 1 minute 18 à écouler à la première période. Les Sabres qui mènent 1-0, alors que, oui, Therrien qui est invective le banc des Sabres de l'autre côté. Alors Varada, lui,
c'est reconnu comme un instigateur. C'est un gars qui aime être impliqué dans les parties. Rob Reid, évidemment, le leader à ce niveau-là. Mais lui, et ça, de son côté, Doug Gilmour le connaissait.
Ah oui. D'ailleurs, c'est Varada qui domine pour les mises en échec chez les Sabres de Buffalo, avec 26 depuis le début de l'année. Alors, c'est un joueur qui aime particulièrement le jeu robuste.
Deux matchs consécutifs et les deux gardiens du Canadien ont été blessés. Voici de quelle façon. Voici la sortie. Regardez,
ah,
ouais. Il se laisse...
Presque choir sur Théodore.
Choir avec le genou et le frapper avec
raison.
Le genou.
Oui.
Et voilà.
Ah, oui.
Et ça, c'est pas l'intention de blesser. Autrement, un joueur qui veut bien saute par-dessus le gardien de but. Tu peux l'accrocher, mais là, c'était vraiment... C'est vraiment laisser tomber sur le gardien. Regardez ici, c'est vraiment pour blesser. Et là, Gilmour, lui...
D'où la réaction de Gilmour, oui. Mais ça aussi, c'est dangereux. Évidemment, mais...
Est-ce qu'on peut dire que Varada va revenir au jeu plus rapidement?
Absolument. Oui.
Que José Théodore.
Oh, he got hit! And Seager goes after him! And Reimer is down!
No, that's Boyle, I'm sorry.
Boyle got a big piece of Reimer. Seager fighting Boyle, but the bigger... Is James Reimer is down. He's not moving right now. He is in some obvious pain.
Hey, listen, there's a goaltender named Eddie Lack who was taken off the ice on a stretcher just the other night.
Oh,
and
boy.
There's no need for that when the NHL is supposed to be protecting goaltenders with a so-called interference clause.
You hope James Reimer is okay. Well, James Reimer to the dressing room after getting hit in the head by Brian Boyle.
Here's Boyle, shorthanded breakaway. Boyle right in, stopped by Mrazek. Brian Boyle looking for his second shorthanded breakaway goal of the series. And this time Mrazek stones him, and then Paquette takes down Mrazek. And that's causing all sorts of mayhem in the Red Wings' end.
Paquette was getting the penalty, and the Red Wings didn't like it, obviously, and taking out their goaltender. Remember that beautiful move he had last time. This time he doesn't quite have as much time. So he knows he's being pressured, tries to go five hole. Mrazek makes the save. Puck's dancing a little bit. He settles it down, tries to go five hole. It's not there. And then Paquette comes through and with the stick just takes Mrazek's feet out. And you can see Abdicator right away goes after Paquette.